Why would you send Jared Kushner to the Middle East when you have Rex Tillerson and Mike Pompeo as secretaries of state? Two incredibly accomplished men. You send him. Why? We found out the answer 6 months after he left office. $2 billion.
My. So while Christie does a great job explaining to us that Jared shouldn't have been the one doing diplomacy in the Middle East, I don't think I'm ready, or none of us should be ready, to hail Chris Christie as the rebellious Republican. As we all know, he was a part of the movement that put Trump in office in the first place, and he spent a lot of time defending Trump when he was first elected. That is, of course, until he decided that he might have a window to run against Trump. And even in this statement, we watch Chris Christie fall short. Let's play this part so everybody can see him fall.
From the Saudis to Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump, $2 billion. And because he did all this and more with his family, he's normalizing this conduct. And now we have another president who's doing exactly the same thing and allowing Hunter Biden to run roughshod, making money from foreign governments and selling access to Joe Biden.
Yeah, still giving me that Bridgegate Chris Christie look and feel. And it seemed like he's not quite ready to be or do or say everything that's truthful, as he missed his words and caved to the political party of Republicans and also politics of the day. We watched him. We literally watched him say something that he knows is factually not true. He said, "Now we have another president doing the same thing, and that Biden was allowing Hunter to make money off foreign governments and run roughshod." Christie is lying. He's simply nodding and winking to the Republican base that he's not completely gone, but he's an alternative to those who are tired of Donald Trump's shenanigans and also establishment politicians like Biden. But here's the problem. It's this level of bowing out. Is this level of counting to the Republican base that's ruining our democracy. And so while so many folks have so many problems with Republican, Chris Christie just showed what is really going on in Washington. Christie knows that Biden, Joe Biden or Hunter Biden is not under investigation for anything that happened since Joe Biden has been president. Not one thing, none of it. But he still was comfortable in saying that the same thing is happening. Hunter Biden is not an advisor to the president. Hunter Biden is not going on missions for this administration. So Chris Christie willing to say this and show up in this manner is absolutely disgusting. Cenk and Ray, I definitely want to hear from both of you on this, but I think it's an important point that we remember people or remind people that is so much going on right now. We just watched a special counsel get announced in the Hunter Biden trial for Merrick Garland. And I think if we are serious about our democracy and serious about what it means to be a leader and hold people accountable, Chris Christie can't show up in this way where you say one thing right and so many other things wrong. Because I feel like he just got it wrong right there, especially as we watch an impeachment about, and we'll play this last clip and then we'll bring you two in, this impeachment about this president about to start taking shape in this Republican Party.
I think anytime you take something this serious, you've got to have facts behind it. Anytime you want to do something in impeachment, we're like the grand jury. We have to make the case to make the indictment. You don't just put something on the floor and say, okay, impeach somebody. This is one of the most serious things you can do as a member of Congress. And I think you've got to go through the process. You've got to have the investigation. And throwing something on the floor actually harms the investigation that we're doing right now. And I don't want to do anything to harm the investigation. Every day we get some new information.
Yeah, and what people might not understand is this is McCarthy replying to his party. He's basically trying to tamp them down on this idea that impeachment is just an investigative tool, something that is small, something to be played with, which is a different tune than they were singing when Donald Trump was last impeached. So, Cenk, I would love to hear what you got to say about your good friends on the conservative side.
Yeah, very good friends. First, let's start with Chris Christie. He's a mixed bag. So I'm with Mondale on the Hunter situation. So look, we've said this 1,000 times on the show. Hunter Biden is not a Ukrainian gas expert and one of the most renowned artists in the country. It's absurd. He's abusing his last name. We all get that, right? But that's not the question. The question is it connected to Joe Biden? Because Hunter Biden's a rando. And so if you want to punish him for that, go ahead. Well, whatever laws he might have broken or not broken, I don't really care at all, right? But I would care a lot if he was affecting policy. Like, for example, if he was in charge of our entire Middle Eastern policy, like Jared Kushner was. But he wasn't. And in fact, on his golden laptop that they think is the greatest, most important political thing in the world, he says, we cannot control my dad, so let's make sure we don't promise that. So how many times have right-wing media told you that about the laptop? No, they made it seem like the laptop's terrible. They didn't explain to you that it actually shows that Joe Biden was not involved. Okay, but let's say that you're in that crowd and you want Chris Christie to hit Hunter Biden and Joe Biden. The biggest allegation was, and totally not true, of course, they bring in the guy, there's no evidence, it's secondhand and he doesn't even believe it, etc. But the allegation is Hunter Biden took 5 million, Joe Biden took 5 million. Well, then you go to Christie's second point about Jared Kushner. Wait a minute, he took 2 billion. He took 2 billion from the Saudis. Now, there are rumors, by the way, that the national security apparatus did not want Jared Kushner to have clearance because of the information he gave the Saudis that he wasn't supposed to give. Okay? And that information could have affected a lot of people's lives. And then, hey, look at that, afterwards, the Saudis invest $2 billion in Jared Kushner. By the way, Jared Kushner is a failed real estate investor. He had 666 Fifth Avenue is considered maybe the worst real estate investment in the history of America. That was Jared Kushner. And the Saudis are like, oh, it is not because he gave us all of these favors while he was in office. We think he is a wonderful investor. That is why we gave him $2 billion. Meanwhile, the LIV Golf tournament is happening. And then they went and bought the PGA. Who's that? Oh, the Saudis, who has tons of golf properties. In fact, his main source of income, which LIV is now using, and the PGA will soon use at a much higher level. Oh, right, Donald J. Trump. So now tens of millions of dollars get funneled to Donald Trump. Yet nobody talks about it. So I like that at least Chris Christie brought that up. And by the way, Democrats, do you exist? Is anyone running against Donald Trump on the Democratic Party side? So RFK Jr. isn't talking about any of that because all he ever does is agree with Donald Trump. No one, Marianne Williams is a great candidate. No one listens to her though. The media goes, don't ever listen to her, she's a progressive. And Joe Biden is sitting in a cave somewhere deep in slumber. Up and at him, Joe. You're the candidate. You're supposed to make some of these points and not leave it to a Republican to make it where he does the mixed messages that Mondale referred to. But God forbid Joe Biden should be bothered to run against a Republican. All right, I've got more, but Ray, weigh in.
Yeah, so first I'll just say I think that the Republicans have really overestimated the sticking power of framing Joe Biden and his family as corrupt and pinning it all on Hunter Biden, because I think they're really underestimating how many Americans have a fail son in their family, how many of us have, just to put it bluntly, an F up relative who, you know, we try to help and you can't help but love them and you want the best for them, but they just keep getting themselves into new stuff. They just keep stepping in it. They, you know, no matter what resources you offer them, they're not getting out of the difficult life that they're living. So I think it actually, the fact that Joe Biden has through all of this time, you know, continued to love and support his son, I think it actually plays the other way than Republicans are expecting it to. So that's the first thing. Second thing, for Chris Christie, the man who fraudulently shut down an entire New Jersey beach so that his family could enjoy it alone, to stand there and talk about, you know, corrupt actions, come on, man. And then to compare, you know, to even sort of frame Joe Biden as this like financially corrupt person, this man who is in, and I don't agree with the things he did, and I don't agree with most of his politics. But I mean, this is a man who was in the Senate for 3 decades and was so poor that he had to borrow money to help pay for his son's cancer treatment after that. I mean, this is somebody who, given every opportunity to be raking in the money, I mean, we see these people become senators and then their finances just skyrocket. They become uber wealthy. Joe Biden, that hasn't happened for him. So it's just so difficult to pitch him as the corrupt candidate, especially when he's running against Donald Trump. And I think that they're missing the politics on this. They're way off the mark. But you know, if they want to keep on it, it only benefits me. It benefits those of us who don't want Donald Trump to be president again.
Yeah, I think both of you are spot on, especially if we consider the fact that how far off do you have to be to consider that Joe Biden, like you said, this is a, and I'm glad you brought this up, Ray. This man went home every night in Washington, D.C. to Delaware by Amtrak. So much so that he didn't even have a house in D.C. like every senator does. And on top of that, when he was the vice president, he was about to sell his house because he couldn't afford it. But Barack Obama paid it off for him. People don't even know that the president paid off this man's house when he was vice president. So that is something that speaks to his character and this idea that he's part of a crime mob. When we see Donald Trump acting as such, and we see, like you said, Chris Christie using his governorship to shut down an entire beach for his family's sake, it just doesn't ring true. I think also Hayes Brown did a wonderful job in a piece for the MSNBC online portal when he wrote that this feels like an important time to highlight the notable lack of evidence that anything the president or his team have done would clear the Constitution bar of high crimes and misdemeanors for impeachment. Republicans have put on months of hearings that have led nowhere and produced a string of supposed star witness whose testimony has fallen flat in impeachable offenses. The same is true of Garland and Mayorkas. And I think it's also important to point out, yes, Hayes make a great point, but knowing and seeing what happened today in the light of the announcement by Merrick Garland, I think it's important that we add that especially the testimony of Archer, who was an associate of Hunter Biden, that was supposed to be this bombshell testimony, and it turned out to be nothing. It was turned out to be a dud. The guy got up there and said Biden didn't talk about business, only talked about family and family. That's it. Like, this is what he does. And the weather. This sounds like Biden being Biden. Old, tired, and want to talk about family and how much he loves them. So this idea that you had this bombshell witness who didn't know anything or didn't know anything about Biden talking about business shows that we in this country find ourselves in a space where we have no Democrats willing to stand up to the party, that party of Donald Trump, where we are pushing and forcing special counsels in cases that don't need to have special counsels. Because this is not a case that a liberal justice brought or a liberal justice department brought. This happened under, talking about the Hunter Biden case, it happened under Donald Trump's administration. It was 2018 when this investigation started and nothing came from it. So this idea that we can relive this sounds just like Kevin McCarthy knowing what he did to Hillary Clinton with the Benghazi. This is the same thing. So yeah. I think, you know, we sit here right now depending on Republicans like Chris Christie and some of those who are in shady or districts that Biden won to do the part that the Democrats are supposed to be doing. And Cenk, we're not gonna get that from them. I don't think you can scare these Republicans enough to hold their colleagues accountable. What about you all?
Yeah, no way. So last couple of things for me. I mean, look, you can tell how disingenuous they are because of Kevin McCarthy's big ally, Marjorie Taylor Greene, introduced impeachment proceedings against Joe Biden on day one when he hadn't done anything yet. I mean, talk about showing your hand. They're like, we don't care about facts. We don't care about evidence. We don't care that he didn't do anything wrong. We don't like the guy. We're just gonna impeach him because of our feelings. And so you can tell who's dishonest. That's just an brazen dishonesty. And that right there is a great summary of the Republican Party today. I think the real corruption comes in campaign contributions, but the Republicans, of course, don't wanna talk about that because they take just as much as the Democrats do. And finally, I agree with Rayvon. Every family has a screw up, and so does the Trump family. And his name is Donald J. Trump.
What would you say?
Yeah, I'll just say that I think that impeachment was an important political tool for the Democrats when they weren't, when we didn't have the presidency, because it played really well with not just their core base, but a broad constituency of the American public. And I'm not saying that Americans by and large are satisfied with Joe Biden's presidency. I think polls have shown that the opposite is true, but it's not in the same brazen way that they were unhappy with Donald Trump as president, right? It's not, you know, the the same sense of urgency, the same sense of fear of our future under Joe Biden that it was under Donald Trump. It's not, you know, the fear that we're going to wake up and turn on the news and World War III is going to have started. You know, speaking broadly in the way that people, particularly less politically engaged people, you know, view this sort of politics. So I think, again, I know I said this already, but I think they're really missing the mark on the politics. I'm sure this will play well with their core base, but I, you know, I think that they have more considerations to make, especially considering that the midterm elections didn't go for them the way that they expected to. So I think that this continuing, you know, hard move to the right is not going to benefit them. And again, I'm fine with that. I am more than fine with the Republicans tripping themselves constantly.
I think that's right. I think you know, this is a perfect opportunity for us to remind people that the Republican Party is not set on growing its party or its membership. It's simply trying to prevent anybody that don't agree with them from voting, or in this case, even living or being free citizens.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.